Coming off a thrilling win over Mark Cairns and Jimmy Nicholls, this stadium was rocking. Nicholls and Cairns were ahead. They were the crowd favorites. When they lost, Cairns and Nicholls were talking about a standing ovation on center court. And Bouillon and Rogers moving on, but everybody wanted to see Jimmy Nicholls and Cairns do their thing.
Yeah, you've seen standing ovations for teams before when they've been Smith and Stoklos that have lost, or Kurian Steffes or Dodden Whitmarsh or somebody like that. But here was an unknown team that marched through this tournament, beat Stoklos and Johnson, beat Frohoff and Ludes, and really had tremendous success and a great crowd following. And they're going to take home a lot of this money. And a big payday for them, fourth place money. They're going to split $5,300. There you see $75,000 overall, $15,000 split by the winners. Really a great performance by Mark Cairns, two-time All-American out of Long Beach State. Jimmy Nicholls was everywhere.
If you're wondering about Brent Frohoff and Ricky Ludes, of course we'll show it to you a little later. They took a fifth this week. They did not play particularly well. And of course, as Paul told you, neither did Johnson and Stoklos after losing their first match play. It wasn't the first round because they got a bye.
They were eliminated eventually by the Brazilians and finished seventh, which is really a horrific finish for them. And that's a team that's struggling right now.
Mike Dodd with the serve, 2-2, semifinal. Bouillon and Dodd digs it. Dodd is right there. Bouillon is up high. Whitmarsh. Yeah, we got it. Big Whit stumbling and tumbling through the sand.
And Bill Bouillon saying, hey, B. Lee, I did not touch that ball. You cost us another point. They only scored three on that side change opportunity, and you gave them two of them.
Coming back to Baltimore, Maryland, don't go away. IMAX Theater and, of course, the Babe Ruth Museum, which houses all the Bambino's artifacts. As that ball is put away, side out.
Of course, the new Oriole Park at Camden Yards, which is absolutely gorgeous.
Pretty close to here, isn't it?
It's almost walking distance.
It's a high fly ball to deep center.
That's right.
Chris Marlowe, Paul Sunderland, Jeff Rogers in the white hat. His partner is Bill Beef Bouillon. Everybody calls him Beef. He's wearing the orange tank top today with the serve. Here he is. It's a 3-2 game. Dodd and Whitmarsh, big favorites, lead by one. Whitmarsh. And Whitmarsh puts it away.
Looks like the Mikes have warmed it up a little bit. They came out a little bit sluggishly. Again, have had at least 3 hours rest from their last match, which they lost the finals of the winner's bracket to Akitubi and Fanoi Moana, the longest names in sports.
Not quite. Almost. I'm going to give you a trivia question.
I mean combined.
Not quite. As Bouillon goes over the top, one team is longer than Akitubi and Fanoi Moana in this tournament.
Well, if you looked it up, I give it to you.
Vandeweghe and Vrbolovic.
By how many letters?
There's Jeff Rogers, 6'2", 185 by 1. 21 characters to 20. I give that credit to
21-20.
Our crack graphics staff. Jerry Weinstein and Mitch Reinhardt here today. They Rogers came up with that little tidbit. Meaningless as it is. But I like it. Jeff Rogers serving. 3-3. Dodd. Nobody up. Nice dig by Rogers. Paul told you he's got great ball control. Question is, can he put the ball away? Beef can, and
Beef
he goes
can.
On two.
That's right. Go on two with the easy play. Get it to your big hitter. Bill Bouillon and Jeff Rogers sitting with the opportunity of their career. Sure, they've had other chances to move forward in big tournaments, but they are staring at Mike Dodd and Mike Whitmarsh, and they stand between them and the finals. It'll be the first ever appearance for both of them in the finals.
Little hip shot, Rogers there again. And he snaps it down the line. Two excellent plays by Jeff Rogers.
Got good ball control. When I say that, I don't mean just receiving serve. People think passing, setting, etc. He has got excellent ball control as a hitter. Right now he's in trouble. Bouillon just trying to spin the ball up into the wind as best he can. That's a part of ball control as well. Finding the back line, finding the sidelines of the court when you're not in great shape in terms of set location and distance from the net.
The heat is definitely a factor. Very, very hot on the court, although it is breezy, which is giving the players some relief. Don Whitmarsh right now, they look very, very sluggish. As Bouillon jammed it, open hand, they're calling open hand. Bouillon was expecting the joust from Whitmarsh on the overset from Mike Dodd, called open hand. Only time you're allowed to use the open hand is when you've got another open hand across from you on the ball, the joust. Pushing and shoving. Yeah, I'm surprised he's not wearing his sunglasses, because usually when B. Lee has his sunglasses, the referee we're talking about, he's asleep. The players wonder, is he awake or is he asleep? But he's watching today.
Did he steal money from you? Or
he beat me in a tournament one year. That makes me. B. Lee, good volleyball player. Hey, Bob Peruka beat Ron Von Hagen in Santa Barbara Double A. How about that?
Yeah, well, you're making an attempt to hit it, and then you can get off. So I gotta go to a job.
And I'll tell you, Bill Bouillon.
Mingus!
Oh, that's a red card.
That's a judgment card. You can't get the tournament director.
Still arguing.
So I gotta go up with a job.
Whitmarsh
like
saying, give him a card.
And Bill Bouillon is asking for the tournament director, and B. Lee is looking at his watch, saying, wait a minute, 20-second timeout.
Yes, it is. The last
here it comes, one more time.
You
over the net.
For them. How can you do that?
We would have called us.
How can you call a stand for another team?
No, that's a good call.
That's a good
call.
That's
a throw. Yeah, that's
a
just
a
throw down.
Timeout.
I'm only saying that you went up like this.
You called a stand, which obviously you thought they were delaying the game.
Remember, Mike Dodd, what is he, the chairman of the board of the AVP?
Yes.
So he specifically knows the rules, supposedly.
Well, and Mike Dodd is one of the most respected players on tour, and he's going to use his gamesmanship and that position in the sport to put pressure on the officials and make them keep things going and keep the pace of the match moving.
Dodd will jump serve, his team trailing by two to Bouillon and Rogers, and an ace. Bouillon and Rogers have to be careful not to let errant plays get them discouraged. We've talked about Bill Bouillon trying to stay calm and play his game.
And Mike Dodd, so experienced, knows how to hammer another nail.
Bouillon off Whitmarsh, he goes and gets it. And Dodd, Rogers is there. Double contact. Indoors, that would have been legal.
Because it was one attempt with two contacts. But on the beach play, the ball came off Jeff Rogers' arms, hit him in the head, double contact.
So timeout taken. The players are still yelling at the refs. And when we come back, it'll be 5-5.
Put a stop to the run, pass a ball. They were playing very, very well, had the 3-2 lead. And have since then just been not good at all.
20-second timeout taken by Rogers and Bouillon, trying to get their act together, talking to each other.
10 seconds.
First time this year. Of course, Jeff Rogers, he started the year with John Brivich, played one tournament, then played four with Bill Sawar, went back to Brivich for four, Boyles for four, back to Brivich, and now he's with Bouillon. So as you see some of these teams, as that ball launched out of bounds, you see some of these teams, it's a lot different. When you're one of the lower echelon players, you are constantly trying
bouncing
to find
around.
The right guy.
And everybody else is bouncing around, so there's a domino effect. The players sort of between, let's say, 16 and 32, they're bouncing all over the place on a weekly basis, and AT&T loves it. You got to have your entries in by noon Wednesday.
Mike Dodd with the serve. 7-5 now, Dodd and Whitmarsh. And Bouillon taps it straight down the line.
Bouillon takes it back, going down
the line. So Bouillon gets a kill.
Sign out.
And the Beef will serve. One of the great nicknames in professional beach volleyball. Haven't seen him much on television. He's one of these guys has all the talent in the world. You see how many partners he has had. Got a great jump serve, good touch, big hitter, good blocker.
Mike! Come on, Mike. Get up, Mike!
There's a dodge, cranks it.
Talk about Bill Bouillon's athletic ability. I mean, is there really that much that separates him from one of his opponents right now, Mike Whitmarsh? Similar in stature, Whitmarsh is a little bit taller. You know, the question is, you know, can he get it done mentally and be tough enough at the end? Mike Dodd certainly still can.
Here's Rogers, and Rogers taps it through.
Rogers really got a seal against a clever hitter like Jeff Rogers. If I were playing against him, I would block his line, and I would force him to hit the ball, make him take away a lot of his shots down the line and over the top of the block, which Mike Whitmarsh can do, and force him to hit the ball at you cross court. Mike Dodd will dig that all day long.
Rogers, deep floater. And Whitmarsh, that's tight. And Rogers has it up. Bouillon going, can't get there.
Mike Dodd goes deep for the side out.
So Dodd and Whitmarsh have the ball. They've won once this year. Of course, that was early in the year in Fort Myers, Florida, when Karch hit the ball right to Dodd. 3 seconds. How would you evaluate Whitmarsh and Dodd's year?
I think they've had a very good year. I think they dropped. They had a real dead spell there for a little while.
That's going to be a point. Nice serve by Dodd.
When for them, they had some bad finishes. Remember in San Jose, they finished 17th. And I talked to Mike Whitmarsh about it. And he said, well, you know, Mike's maybe feeling a little tired. But then they bounced right back with a fourth, a second, a third, and a fifth. They're very, very consistent among the top group of players in terms of finishes. But they would like very much to win another tournament, especially while Kari and Steffes are on the shelf.
Rogers.
Whitmarsh and Dodd have assumed command since the argument. It's been Marlo, Paul Sunderland, Mike Dodd, Mike Whitmarsh really playing well now after a wake-up call. Bill Bullion and his partner Jeff Rogers trying to hang in. We were tied at 5, but Dodd and Whitmarsh are starting to stroke it. Rogers is there, and Beef can't pull it out.
Mike Dodd with a sharp angle.
Point, Whitmarsh and Dodd.
That's a great get by Jeff Rogers. On a very, very good cut shot. Now, Bullion makes a decision that he can't get. I would let the ball go into the net, get down, and play it below. But in hindsight, it's easy to make. You got to make an instantaneous decision, and Bullion decided that he had to pokey the ball straight up.
Same timeout call by Dodd and Whitmarsh.
All right, the mics, you see, third, second, a win in Fort Myers. Fourth, third, fifth, second, third, fifth. They had an awful weekend in San Jose, the lost weekend, a fourth, a second, third, and a fifth. Although I think some people would say, why can't those guys win more? I think one of the problems, they do not have a strong serving game. The easiest serving team on the beach.
Well, no doubt that hurts them. It's much harder for them to score points. And when you consider two very long days of competition, other teams are scoring maybe 15% of their points off of jump serving, whereas this team is scoring virtually none.
Big hit by Bullion.
Their games take longer because even against the lower-ranked teams, they're not able to finish them off through their good, tough jump serving because they just don't possess it.
So Bullion will serve. He won the Evian Indoor Qualifier, first tournament of the year with Dan Vrbolovic, then got fifth at Madison Square Garden, but could not continue it with Vrbolovic.
Rebound!
Dodd, Bullion is there. Pretty quick in the backcourt.
Nobody!
Nanny puts it away.
Well, that's a nice play by Bill Bullion. Good read right away, and it comes right back with a score.
Timeout on the court. Rogers and Beef trailing the mics by 3. His partner Jeff Rogers had a little earlier. We were tied at 5, and then a controversial play where the referee blew a throw call, or at least blew the whistle on a throw call, and correctly done by Brant Lee. He did throw it, but... Bullion got a little upset, and Dodd and Whitmarsh took control.
And you could tell, you know, after the side change, after the controversial play, Bill Bullion looked up to us and said, well, you know, what did you think of it? What did the replay show? And it just leads me to think that obviously he's still thinking about it way too long.
Yeah, Sunday gave him a thumbs down, like death to the Trojans.
That's right.
Go to the later.
It was a good call. Shut up and go play. But they, once again, have had a very, very good tournament. Bullion blocking, Jeff Rogers playing good defense. A team that I would not want to play when they were on their game.
Bullion off the block.
Do you have the bracket?
Sign out.
Yes, I do.
Okay. Bullion and Rogers have it. Of course, the brackets, reason we're referring is that Johnson and Stokos made this tournament a little unusual this week, as Bullion has a chance for a point. Nice shot! He clubbed it off Whitmarsh, out of bounds, and a point.
Would have done that at 5-5. We never would have had the controversy.
3:49 to go in the game. Bullion and Rogers trying to come back.
Do they have a nice...
Laurie Schrammer.
You come to Baltimore, you got to grease up just about every area, Paul.
If you got a haircut like that, you do.
Semi-final action. This is center court. I'm Chris Marlowe. My partner is Paul Sunderland, the Harborview Marine and Yacht Club, home of many world-class sailing events over the years, but making its debut with volleyball here in the Nestle Open. The fans are really excited about volleyball. normally, when you get a first-time site, you don't get the sellout crowds. Well, we have here a couple of VIP seats, of course.
Bill Bullion at the line, 7.
Packed all day yesterday, all day today, and a knowledgeable crowd. People back here watching all the tournaments.
There's Bill Bullion serving. Back on the good side. Maybe they can make some points here. Dodd, Bullion has it up. Chance for a point. Beat. Bullion's in.
A blast by Beat for a point. 8.
All around, a great volleyball play, transition score. Bullion with a fake block, backs up. This is the very end of the play, but Ate, nice dig overhand, exactly as you're supposed to do it, and then Jeff Rogers digging to get there and make the good set.
Those are the plays that you're allowed to dig overhand. A hard-driven ball, that was. As Bullion drops the play, looking at Dodd and Whitmarsh. 8 serving 13. Winner plays Manoa, Moana, and Akintubi.
Oh, come on!
Dodd, blocked by Rogers.
With the blocks.
Rogers doing a little bit of blocking right now.
13.
Jeff Rogers laughing about it, just giving Beaver a bit of a break here. And they are slowly creeping back into this match. First, I'm just going to say, first stuff block of the match for Rogers and Bullion. And if their team was really going to put a lot of pressure on Dodd and Whitmarsh, Bullion would have to get at least a couple. Kind of ironic that Rogers gets their only stuff block and gets it pretty late.
6.3 seconds remaining in this men's contenders bracket final.
So Dodd and Whitmarsh taking a blow so far this year. Crane Steph is stuck at 198,000. Johnson and Stoko 72 apiece. Dodd and Whitmarsh, Rudy, Brent Frohoff. Of course, the big question next week, can Karch Karai play? And if Karch can't play, who would Kent Steffes play with? I talked to him on Saturday morning, and he told me he wants to play with someone he can win with, and he'd like to play with Jose Loyola. Mm. He's going to call him. He's going to talk to him. Loyola turned him down this week to stay with Angino.
Well, Kent has asked a number of players.
Well,
you qualified. He wants to play with somebody he can win with.
That's Johnson.
Johnson, right.
Loyola.
Loyola.
Heidel.
Ludes.
Okay.
He asked all those guys to play.
Okay.
And they would not break up their partnerships. And so Steffes says, you know, if I can't play with a top guy, I'm going to stay home. Boy, when he comes out, he'll be a little bit amped and anxious to play again, I would say.
I think so. What do you think about Steffes and Loyola? Steffes told me, he said, I think we'd be great. Kind of surprising statement from Kent. As Whitmarsh is up high. Big Whit restores order with the stuff block at the vertical variety.
Yeah, Dodd and Whitmarsh had relaxed just a little bit after taking a significant lead, and Rogers and Bullion were creeping back in. But that stuff block to take it to 14 should just about do it.
Championship, well, I should say championship point. It's a match point. Dodd is there. Whitmarsh.
Oh, great shot.
Yes.
And there it is, Whitmarsh with the angle.
The final point goes to Dodd and Whitmarsh after a very, very slow start. The veterans plug away and take care of Beef Bullion and Jeff Rogers. We're coming back after this.
Bill Bullion, a career best finish for both those two.